centered around the youth of Wilmington, and we're all very, very proud of that. Toward that end, in May, we are going to dedicate this field formally in Dick Scanlon's name, but we thought to begin the season, we certainly should have a sign that appropriately recognizes this field. I'll speak as quickly as I can, because that's the sort of precarious what we're holding up there. And Mark Peter's job is on the line to make sure it doesn't fall. I want to thank everybody for being here, but especially acknowledge the Scanlon family, who really came through with the ideas for the sign, and especially Don Onicet and Bud Pronsky, who's designing the sign. I think you're going to really appreciate. They took the genesis of the idea from the Scanlons, and it's really very, very nice. And Selectman Bob Pound brought this idea to the town meeting. We thank him very much and acknowledge him for that. I would recognize that we also have here with us the superintendent of schools, Dr. Geraldine O'Donnell, the principal of the high school, Ed Woods, and I know a host of other very, very important people. Because it's Wilmington, Tewksbury, it makes it very special. Both of these towns have a sense of rivalry, but also, I think, a sense of sportsmanship. And it's great to see Wilmington and Tewksbury here to open up this field. Toward that end, for the purpose of a few words, representing the Tewksbury Athletic Department, Coach Bob McKay.
The people in Wilmington are very fortunate, or we're very fortunate to have such an outstanding coach as Dick Scanlon. His teams were always well coached and performed as Dick did, with a lot of class. Dick was one of the veteran coaches who always perpetuated fair play in this fierce rivalry between Tewksbury and Wilmington. Dick was a personal friend of mine. His coaching expertise touched many Wilmington athletes and coaches. And from the bottom of my heart, wherever you are, Dick, I'll miss you.
Athletic director, a former baseball coach himself, and somebody who was very instrumental in this day and in May. And is this because there is a glare? Is that what you're doing? Okay. Jim Gillis.
On behalf of all of the student athletes here at Wilmington High School and the coaches, I really would like to thank you, and I appreciate everyone being here and a part of this special day. As Mike mentioned, Dick would really frown on a day like this. But I can tell you one thing. He's already taken care of all the geese out there. You notice there aren't any geese. So you know his presence is here someplace. He'd come down here Saturdays, Sundays, and chase the geese off his family. So it's really appropriate that today that we unveil this sign to him in his memory. And we're going to miss him. And thank you all again.
Thank you very much, Jim. With all due respect to my good friends in Tewksbury, the hard-hitting Redmen, I hope you go 18-2 this year, and I hope these are the two losses. But good luck to you. But to the new coach and the baseball team, I know you'll do the town proud, and we wish you the very, very best. And now I would like to call on the love of Dick's life, his family. I'd like to ask Richard and Stan and Susan and Michael to come forward. And, of course, a wonderful person in everybody's life, Kay Scanlon. And we'll ask them first to unveil the sign, and then we'll ask Kay to say a few words. And following the unveiling, we're going to ask Timmy, Kay and Dick's grandson, Richard's son, to throw out the first ball. So we'll let you get out of the way, and it's all yours. Okay.
Thank you.
on the gear again, I guess, if I had to. And Jim is going to be throwing out the first ball, I think, momentarily, and if you are, you're welcome to stay around and cheer the team on, and at least cheer Tim on as he makes the first call strike. This hat is wonderful, Jim Gillis. You'll know, if you guys would all just show your hat the other way, you'll see what it says. It's DS in honor of Dick Scanlon. They'll be wearing that hat all year. So it's going to be a year-long tribute to just a great gentleman who has a great family that he's left us. Thank you all for being here. We hope to see you on May 25th when we do a formal dedication of the baseball field. We unveil a plaque that's being made, and we set it in granite forever and ever. Thanks very much.
coach.
Certainly was long enough for us to appreciate the need and understand why this.
countless contributions to the lives of all of us in this community. And we are very, very grateful to call her one of our own. I want to recognize the wonderful wife of Coach Hanlon. Thank you.
Greatly. commitment, talked about dedication, talked about love. Always talked about love. Because he loved all of his kids. That's what this is all about. He's behind this. I have to tell you, there was always another side of Dick. He was like, always conspiring to do something that usually was positive, very positive. And today, as an athletic director, he made me very nervous because I thought somehow he was conspiring with Pete Mascarella, the Redding coach. Up until 5 minutes ago, I'm still looking for Redding. And I'm looking, looking, looking. I'm saying, no Redding, no ball game. How good is this going to be? You know, what are you doing to me? And I turned to Aldo and I said, listen, you know, try to delay things for people without a reception afterwards. Because I'm going to get on the phone. And I know Redding knows because I'm the state tournament director. I'm going over all the forms. And he goes, it's Redding at Bloomington Tournament. Peter, an outstanding coach. And was playing back with Dick and started this Memorial Day tournament with Dick. And I want to thank Redding and Pete. And I know you're the Redding players over here. They're fantastic for all of us. And I know that they're excited about being here and being a part of this. But anyway, Peter, you know, I thought that you and Dick really conspired to give me both great years. Thank you. On behalf of the Scandler family and the athletic department, I'm very proud to announce today creation of a major athletic award, male and female, criteria established by the Scanlon family and the athletic department. I think sums it up about Richard J. Dick Scanlon. That award will go to a male or female who demonstrates courage, humility, competitive spirit. And I think that sums it up because Dick was a very humble, humble guy. He was very competitive.
Have our gratitude for paying tribute to the gentleman that